Jeff here with Digital Trends, and we're looking at the Motorola Photon Q 4G LTE. So this is the newest Motorola, the only Motorola phone on Sprint right now, and it replaces the Motorola Photon, which came out a year ago. As you can see on the back here, it's got a little bit of a razor-ish design, a little flimsy plastic design there on the back. The sides here appear to be metal, so it's a little better construction on the front. And this runs Android 4.0, so you have these face buttons that are built into the screen there. And there are a few enhancements that Motorola has added. You can manipulate screens, add a new one, stuff like that. And it has a very colorful, very nice vibe to it, a lot different than the old Moto Blur, or they called it the Ninja Blur, the past Motorola phones. Have been a little dark, a little bleak, a little boring. So you can actually manipulate this little widget here up front, get some weather, battery life. It's nice. It doesn't come with a ton of apps, which is good. You can download any other apps that you want, but not a lot of bloatware. It does come with Smart Actions, which we'll find here. We'll mess with it. We just have one enabled right now, but you can make different smart actions. Basically, you could tell it whenever you go home at night, it could turn on Wi-Fi and then turn it off when you leave the vicinity, or different things. You can kind of program your phone to do what you want. It's a really cool app if you're willing to invest in it. So overall, it looks has these same cutoff corners. Doesn't have the stand that you might remember from a lot of Sprint phones have a kickstand. This does not have that. It's a little thick. It's a little thinner than the original Droid. But a little thicker than, you know, your Galaxy S3 or some of the newer phones. But the reason it's a little thicker is because it has a full slide-out QWERTY keyboard. And this is, it's not going to sound good. This is not just any old keyboard. This is actually a very, very good keyboard. So it has a full number row. Each individual key lights up in the dark, so you can see exactly what you're typing in the dark. Even has caps lock and some advanced features. Tab is nice. Takes a little bit of getting used to, like any keyboard would when you're used to touch typing. But having a keyboard is really, really useful, especially because you can see the whole screen while you're typing. And it can get a little faster once you get used to it than standard touch typing. Less errors as well. And this is, it's pretty much the same keyboard as the Motorola Droid, the Droid 4 and the Droid 3. And probably the best keyboard, at least the best keyboard that I've tested on the market today. So overall, the phone, we have an in-depth review, you can read a little more. But pretty good. Camera's a little weak, but better than past Motorola phones. There aren't a lot of weak points about this. Probably our number one complaint was that the battery drains a little bit fast when you're idling. But other than that, it's an extremely good option, especially if you're looking for this keyboard. And there's not a lot of other keyboard or phones on Sprint. So this is the Motorola Photon Q.